Thanks for checking out my video. I didn't film an on-camera intro, so this will have to do. On this trip, I hiked in and camped overnight with a fellow Marine, who is basically the stepson of a Marine I went to ground radio repair school with in 29 Palms back in the day. In this video, we get up, break camp, and do a day hike to enjoy the views, which hopefully look a lot better now, thanks to my new Canon M50 Mark II that I shot it with. This is a shorter version of the full video, which you can see by heading over to my Buy Me a Coffee page linked below, as well as in my profile. The longer version includes clips from the night before, so please head over to Buy Me a Coffee and sign up if you want to see the full video. Now, sit back and enjoy as I show my fellow devil dog the sights of Aokigahara. AK-47 by Black Rifle Coffee Company. When you absolutely, positively gotta wake up every last mother in the camp, except no substitute. Well, we got our gear packed up, had a nice, relaxing chill out, had some brews, had some good food. Here it's raining a little bit now, but that shouldn't be too much of a problem, it's not that bad. So now that it's daytime and we can actually see the forest, we're gonna head out and check it out and bring you along and let you enjoy the video. Back on the main road. This goes back from where we came and also the route I took with my bro frame of travel. But this time we're going onward and upward, both figuratively and literally.
Trekking.
Yep, this is pointing in the direction of Fuji. So we'll be a slight incline all the way up to we get to the trail, the turn off for the road. This is an interesting spot we're at right now. If I pan around, let me just get my big head out of the way, let's see. If you see, this looks pretty much like, except for you do see some lava rocks there, but in general, this is a pretty typical forest that you see most other places in the world that are not Aokigahara. But we are still very much in the center of it. It's just that this is kind of a high spot, so the lava when it erupted was not able to come up this high. So this looks kind of like a typical North American deciduous forest. Kind of reminds me, I'm from Indiana, so the forest's back home. It's none of this scraggly, craggly rock, and you see it is actual dirt for the trail for the most part. So this is a part of Aokigahara you don't typically see in your typical "ooh, I'm going to go to Aokigahara and hang out with the ghosts" videos. As Brendan pointed out here, looks like we're going through a couple crossed sabers, Marine Corps style wedding. Gonna make us work for this last few bits. A few-ish bits, I don't know. I haven't checked the maps to see where we're at. Hello, super green rock. It's springtime now, so it's the perfect time to see the super green moss at its super green peak. For example. This is the first time I've seen in Aokigahara ones that look like they are definitely have some iron in them, possibly, depending on the redness. Up until now, I had not seen on the floor red rocks like that. So, I guess there could be some credence to there being parts in the forest that have iron deposits in them, but still, I've already seen Japanese sources that say, yes, if you get your magnet or get your compass close to those kind of rocks, yes, it might start, you know, going a bit nuts or deflecting off of true north. But other than that, if you're standing upright like I am right now, as you can see right here, let it settle down. It's not spinning around 360. I know we're going south, southeast, and that's basically what the compass is saying. Of course, for your view, it's reversed, but yeah, compasses still work here, people. Don't believe the myths and do your own research before you go and repeat something that's not true. Thank you. Well, we're here. There's the road right there, and from where we continued our journey in the morning, the terrain has been pretty much like this. Only just now, right by the road, are we starting to see the lava rocks. But in this spot, it's pretty open, not too crazy with the undulating surface from the lava rock. So the trail I was looking for, that at least according to one source map that should have been in this area, I can't see it, so we're going to get back on the road and walk on back down, give our feet a break, and enjoy the sights from the road. There you go, victory pose. Didn't get any real good footage of this area on my Sea of Trees to Summit video that I did with my bro Frame of Travel. But this is our old hood that we took. We started from 71 there, and then I just see some of the forest as I pan around. Then we went this way, and this goes all the way up to the fifth station. So signs all the way, and pretty much just like this. There are some rougher spots, and we actually veered off the trail and then got back on it. But some interesting things to see there. But our mission for today is to get back around this way. So gonna keep on keeping on. This might look somewhat familiar if for those that were able to see a certain video before it got taken down. You can fill in the blanks on the rest of that. But that was in through this area over here, I'm guessing. But that's not where we're going to go. We got to go this way. Right now, by the behind the ice cave, where we'll be heading over, taking the trail that goes between it from the ice cave to the wind cave, and continuing on.
Kind of creepy how the trees are just hanging towards
yeah,
the trail.
This is only in this section. Makes this little tunnel of trees where they're leaning over.
Quite ominous.
Yeah.
Very cinematic.
Yep. And the birds are quite active today. I didn't say it on camera earlier, but talking to Brendan, the times I've gone has been towards the fall, late fall. But here it is May. It is May, what, 11th? 10th, 11th? What is the date?
It's the 11th, yeah.
Okay, yeah, May 11th. 2021. Birds are quite chirpy. Getting towards the end here, let me get this final kind of spurt, and then we should be close to the main road that goes to the fifth station, to Fuji. But I'm going to give us one last little gut check here. So, getting towards the end though. Yeah, there we go. So what do you think?
Outstanding, absolutely, I'd say euphoric.
Yeah,
being there.
Yeah, it's a trip. I mean, the scenery, the layout, the wildlife, plants, etc., of where we're at.
The leeches.
Yeah, the ninja leeches.
That we're just finding out now about.
Yeah, I just told him about the. I'd kind of forgotten about them too, because it's mainly more. Top of the summer issue, but in Japan, you go on Kurt Bell, aka Softy Papa, he tells the good news that they have ninja leeches. I guess predator ninja leeches. They can sense, almost ate it, meant to do that. They can sense your body heat, and then they drop down on you from the overhanging leaves and suck your blood. I hate leeches, so I'm just like, ugh. So I told him the good news is, oh, wonderful, terrific. So thanks for telling me now, but we've been, just did a check of each other. We'll check again. Should be all right. It's still cool up here.
Yeah, it doesn't make it any less beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true though, yeah. So anyway, but again, one less uphill here. Be back with you in a bit. Well, we're back in the car, got our gear packed up, settled in for the drive home. I'm probably gonna get some grub on the way there.
Oh, absolutely.
Sure. Yeah, some good grub. None of this,
dry catfish.
Yeah, we tried to hook ourselves up with some good grub, you know, as best we could out of the convenience store, but still, it doesn't beat you having a nice table to sit down to, relax, you know. Well, you'll be able to have a beer. I'll be the one driving, so I can't have a beer, unfortunately. But, glad you had a good time.
Well, we did. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Glad that I was able to bring you along. Glad you can make it out. Bit of a rough start logistically, but we got her settled, got her taken care of. So, got you to have an adventure. Hopefully, you'll remember it for at least a couple of weeks.
Absolutely.
So, a couple of weeks.
A little bit more than that.
Yeah, a little bit more than that. All right. So, good. Glad you came along. Had a good time with you, Brandon. Thanks for coming out.
Thanks for inviting.
Hope you enjoyed it. May not have been my best edited video. Always trying to improve on that. This was kind of a run and gun style with a better camera though. Hope you noticed that. But it is what it is. Hope you enjoyed it. See you in the next one.